Sister Carmel.
Reading from the book of Psalms 91, from the beginning to the end. He that dwelleth in the secret place of the Most High shall abide under the shadow of the Almighty.
I will say of the Lord, He is my refuge, my fortress, my God, in Him will I trust.
Surely He shall deliver thee from the snare of the fowler and from the noisome pestilence.
He shall cover thee with His feathers and with wings.
Thou shalt not be afraid for the terror by night, nor for the arrow that flieth by day,
nor for the pestilence that walketh in darkness, nor for the destruction that wasteth at noonday.
1,000 shall fall at thy side, and 10,000 at thy right hand, but it shall not come nigh thee.
Only with thine eyes shalt thou and see them.
Because thou hast made thee Lord, which is my refuge, even the Most High thy habitation.
There shall no evil befall thee, neither shall any come nigh thy dwelling.
For He shall give His angels charge over thee, to keep thee in all thy ways.
They shall bear thee up.
Thou shalt tread upon the lion and adder, the young lion and the dragon shalt thou trample under feet.
Because He has set His power upon thee.
He shall call upon me, and I will answer him. I will be with him in trouble. I will deliver him and honor him. Here ends the
reading. Any sickness, don't treat on your own. Consult a good physician, preferably authorized physicians. Psalm 91 verse 1. Psalm 91 verse 1. He that dwelleth in the secret place of the Most High shall abide under the shadow of the Almighty. He will deliver you from plagues, from horror, from terror. We've got a lot of promises in Psalm 91. But all these promises are not just given to any Christian, not just to any believer. It is very clearly said, He that dwelleth in the secret place of the Most High. It is not just for a believer who is in the camp. It is not just for an Israelite who has come to the court of the Lord. It is not even for a priest who has come into the holy place of the tabernacle. But all these promises are to the believer. He that dwelleth in the secret place of the Most High. He that dwelleth in the most holy place. In the tabernacle, there are three areas: the outer court, holy place, and the most holy place. But all these promises are given to someone who dwells in the most holy place of the Lord. That is called the secret place of the Most High. How to reach the secret place of the Most High, or how to reach the Holy of Holies? We often sing a lovely chorus, "Lead me into the most holy place." Enne ulle alaithichal. Unan maha parisutta sthalathukulle. Ennayum alaithu chellum. God willing, maybe next Sunday I'll speak to you how we can go into the most holy place. How can we go into the most holy place? This morning just I'm going to give you a running commentary on Psalm 91. just an explanation on verses. So these promises are given to those who dwell in the secret place of the Most High. Because in the secret place of the Most High, the Shekinah glory is there. The Shekinah glory is not in the outer court. The Shekinah glory is not in the holy place. The Shekinah glory is in the most holy place. So here the psalmist says, that is under the shadow of the Almighty. That is under the shadow of the Almighty. When you stand in the most holy place, you are standing in the shadow of the Almighty. So when you dwell in the secret place of the Most High, you are under the shadow of the Almighty. Verse 2. I will say of the Lord, I will say of the Lord, He is my refuge, my fortress, my God, in Him will I trust. So in verse 2, we have got a 4-point confession. So in verse 2, we see a 4-part confession. Number 1, he that dwelleth in the secret place of the Most High confesses that the God is my refuge. When I stand in the most holy place, my confession is, the God is my refuge. It's not only to tell others, it's not only to tell within myself, tell the Lord, Lord, you are my refuge. There's nowhere I can find my refuge. You are my refuge. And you are my fortress, you are wall around me. You are wall around me. Number 3, Lord Yahweh, He who is the unchanging one. Yahweh, you are not only God of Israel, you are my God. You are not only God of this nation, you are personally my God. You are my refuge, Yahweh my refuge, Yahweh my fortress, Yahweh my God, Yahweh, I will trust in you. Tell him, I will trust in you. In verse 4 he says, under his wings shall thou trust. In the outset I want to tell you, Psalm 91, we don't know who has written that. But we could see is almost a continuation of Psalm 90. The last 4 words in Psalm 90 is also seen in Psalm 91. Psalm 90 is written by Moses. So Psalm 91 could be also written by Moses. I assume, I conjure. And that suits me very well. It was written by Moses. And I imagine it like this. It's a conversation between Moses and Joshua. Moses was instructing Joshua. I just take it like that. Then you can understand this psalm better. So Moses says the general condition, he that dwells in the secret place of the Most High shall abide under the shadow of the Almighty. Then Moses says, I will say of the Lord, He is my refuge, my fortress, my God, in Him I will trust. And in verse 4 he says, trust, tells Joshua, I take it like that, trust in the shadow, in the shield of His wings. Because it says very clearly, under His wings shall thou trust. When can I stand under His wings? If I go to the most holy place. If I go to most holy place, I am under the shadow of His wings. So when I trust under the shadow of His wings, His truth shall be my shield and my buckler. His truth. He is faithful. He is able to protect me. His truth shall be my shield, my buckler. We'll go to verses 3 and 4. Surely, Moses tells Joshua, surely, with no shadow of doubt, surely he shall, Yahweh shall, deliver you. Deliver Joshua. We can take it for you. Deliver Joe. Deliver, just put your name, deliver Simon. Surely he shall deliver you from the snare of the fowler and from the noisome or deadly pestilence, corona or Ebola, whatever it may be. It's a noisome pestilence. That are Moses' prophetic words. People are making more noise about this pestilence. Every TV, every media is making a noise about this pestilence. So we can call that a noisome pestilence. He shall cover thee with his feathers, and under his wings shall thou trust. His truth shall be thy shield and buckler. So in verse 3 we see, surely with no shadow of doubt. Three promises are given. Number one, surely he shall deliver thee from the snare of the fowler. So the people have, there are cunning people around us. Very cunning people. In different way they want to put us into trap. பிரச்சனைக்குள்ள மாட்டியோட பார்க்குற நிறைய ஃப்ரெண்ட்ஸ் நம்ம சுற்றி இருப்பாங்க, ரிலேட்டிவ்ஸ் இருப்பாங்க, மக்கள் இருப்பாங்க. A fowler, as he spread net for the feet of an unaware bird. They will be spreading a net when you are not aware of it, when you are unaware of it. So what happens? Surely, with no shadow of doubt, surely he will deliver you, even if you are caught. Even if you are caught unaware, some problem, some financial transaction. It's a prophecy to somebody. Even this morning I was praying for somebody. Their feet are caught in a net. They are unable to come out. They are unable to come out. It is the word of the Lord. If you know how to stand in the secret place of the Most High, when you put your trust under his wings, in the name of Jesus, I tell you, he shall deliver you from the snare of the fowler. You are already caught in the snare of the fowler. It's a prophetic utterance to somebody here in this morning. Your feet is already caught in the snare of the fowler. He's a fowler. உன்னை உன் ஆத்மாவே உன்னுடைய சொத்த சுகத்தை வேட்டையாட துடிக்கிற தந்திரமான வேட்டைக்காரன், உன் கால் மாட்டிக்கிட்டு இருக்குது. இயேசுவின் நாமத்தில் தீர்க்க தரிசனமாய் சொல்லுகிறேன், அவர் அந்த கண்ணிக்கு ஓரிஷனமாறவா, ஆச்சரியமாய் உன்னை விலக்கி காப்பா. நம்பர் டூ, he shall deliver thee from the noisome deadly pestilence, the plague. Number three, he shall cover thee with his feathers. There's great warmth in his feathers. The warmth of the mother under his feathers. The three promises in verses 3 and 4, he shall deliver thee from the snare of the fowler. He shall deliver thee from the noisome pestilence. Surely he shall cover thee with his feathers. We go to verses 5 and 6. Thou shalt not be afraid for the terror by night, nor for the arrow that flieth by day, nor for the pestilence that walketh in darkness, nor for the destruction that wasteth at noonday. So when you are standing in the most holy place, when you are in the secret place of the Most High, when you are under the shadow of the Almighty, four things will take place. You need not be afraid of four things. Make a note of it. You need not be afraid of four things. Number one, to the terror by night. Night is a time where you can do nothing. Night is a time where you can do nothing. When you are sleeping, you cannot fight against a thief. When you are sleeping, you cannot even kill a mosquito. You cannot do anything against a scorpion. You cannot do anything against a cobra. When you are sleeping, almost you are dead. Some people are really dead when they are sleeping. When you are sleeping, you cannot do anything. So when the terror by night, it speaks about it, you cannot do anything about it. Your intelligence cannot do anything. You are sleeping. Your intelligence cannot stop a mosquito. Your intelligence cannot stop a thief. Your intelligence cannot stop a scorpion when you are sleeping, when you are sound asleep. You may have a lot of protections taken earlier, but when you are sleeping, you cannot fight against anything. The very protection when you are sleeping is not even the watchman. The watchman may become the killer. But when you are standing in the most holy place, you need not be worried about the night. You cannot do anything about it, but you need not be worried about it. Because they are in the most safety place. For the terror by night. For the arrow that flyeth by day. The arrow that flyeth by day. See, people are doing things against you. They are shooting arrows against you. They speak bad about you. They fight against you. They quarrel against you. They make false petitions against you, false complaints against you. Your own people. Maybe your mother-in-law, your daughter-in-law, shooting arrows against you. If you read the Bible carefully, there's a small insight. God doesn't have bow or arrow in his hand. Whenever we talk about God, God has got sword. God has got sword. Devil has got bow and arrow. So if I got a sword in my hand, I have to stand face to face and fight. Because I got a sword in my hand, I cannot stand in dark, I cannot hide somewhere and fight with sword. Face to face, straight to straight. One to one fight. That is the sword. But arrow, hiding somewhere and shooting. Arrow is hiding somewhere and shooting. Not fighting face to face. Hiding somewhere and shooting is the arrow that flyeth in the day. It's a daytime. We may not know from where that arrow comes. The arrow is not the problem. One who is shooting the arrow, he is the problem. In Tamil, there is a powerful saying. Eidavanirka ambai novadhi enna. Eidavanirka ambai novadhi enna. Ambu is not the problem. Arrow is not the problem. The fowler, the archer is the problem. But you need not be afraid of the terror by night or for the arrow that flyeth by day. Number three, for the pestilence that walketh in darkness. You cannot see corona with your eyes. And one thing I just failed to tell you about the safety measures for corona. Using a mask, it is 99.9% not necessary. Many a time it is adverse. Number one, only an infected person must use mask. Or somebody who is dealing with an infected person must use mask. Number two, whenever you use mask, you're prone to be more careless because you know that you've got a safety measure. But the virus is very small, much smaller than a bacteria. Most of the ordinary masks cannot protect that bacteria. Number three, whenever you want to set the mask right, you tend to touch your face more frequently than when you are not using your mask. So it is a pestilence that walks in darkness. You cannot see it. You know how it will touch, it will affect you. It's not only I'm talking about a viral infection. Any infection that can be caused by a viral, even a common flu, a pneumonia, a corona, whatever it may be. It walks in darkness. But more than viral infection, there's so many problems that you are not aware of it. You are not aware of it. Whether I am touching a person will cause me an infection or not. The arrow of Cupid will cause a stupid infection. Your smile can cause infection. It will spoil your life. Anytime you say, what is wrong in it? What is wrong in it? What is wrong in it? It will prove it was fatally wrong. You cannot do anything about it later. You cannot do anything about it later. It walks in darkness. Many sin, many problems, many premarital love, many relationship, brother, brother, friend, friend. You have to be very careful. You have to be very careful. It walks in darkness. Number four, for the destruction that wasteth noonday. Patta pahalla. So many distractions, accidents. Once in every 4 minutes, somebody is dying in India, less than 4 minutes. Maybe in every 7 minutes, 2 people are dying in India. You and I are not dead. It's God's mercy. Every 7 minutes, 2 people are dying. 2 people are dying somewhere in India because of road accident. That's the destruction that wasteth at noonday. War, natural calamities like earthquake, cyclone, tsunami. How many people are dead? Why the earthquake has not killed us? We are traveling in train, we are traveling in car, we are traveling in plane. So many people died. Why are we not dead? So for the destruction that wasteth at noonday, we need not be afraid as long as we are in the most holy place. So 4 things we see in verses 5 and 6. You shall not be afraid of the terror by night, about which you can do nothing. About which you can do nothing. But you need not be afraid. The arrow that flyeth by day, the secret onslaughts against you. Rahasyamaga vanakurodhama edukapadugira kaariyanga. You need not be afraid. For the pestilence that walketh in darkness, irulil nadamadum kollaru, you cannot see it. You cannot see it. Which water, which air, which surface, you may not know. For the destruction that wasteth at noonday, maybe something like an accident or a natural calamity. As the days of horror or nights of terror, you need not be afraid. Verses 7 and 8 is very, very important. 1,000 shall fall at thy side and 10,000 at thy right hand, but it shall not come nigh thee. Only with thine eyes shall thou behold and see the reward of wicked. So those who are fallen, those who are wasted, die in an accident, or die of a sickness, are they only wicked? Here it says, thou shalt behold and see the reward of the wicked. It will not touch you. But we should understand that in a proper perspective. All those who are affected, all those who are physically die in an accident or of sickness, we cannot immediately say they are wicked. Please listen carefully. In Ecclesiastes, Purasangi, in Ecclesiastes chapter 9, verses 2 and 3, all things come alike to all. All things come alike to all. There is one event to the righteous and to the wicked. Same event to the wicked. The good man to the clean and to the unclean. to him that sacrificeth, and to him that sacrificeth not. One who goes to the church and one who doesn't go to the church. As is the good, so is the sinner. And he that sweareth, as that feareth an oath. For everybody. This is an evil among all things that are done under the sun. That there is one event unto all. Everybody is the same thing. Yea, also the heart of the sons of men is full of evil. The heart of the sons of men is full of evil, and madness is their heart. Madness is their heart while they live, and after that they go to the dead. It explains to everybody in the same way, to the good and to the bad, to the righteous and to the unrighteous, to one who sacrifices and one who doesn't sacrifice us. Everybody, it is the same thing. Everybody dies. Everybody can meet with a road accident. What does it mean? What does it mean? The Lord says that I will protect. If you read Psalm 73, I love to read the whole psalm, but I don't know how much the time will permit me. If you got a copy of the Bible, kindly turn with me to Psalm 73. And media, if you can screen Psalm 73, please do it. Psalm 73, we are just going to have a reading of Psalm 73. It's a psalm of Asaph. Truly, God is good to Israel, even to such as are of clean heart. If you are a clean heart, if you are of a clean heart, God is good. But as for me, my feet were almost gone. My steps had well nigh slipped. Really, God is good, but I made a fatal mistake. I was about to make a very big mistake. My feet were almost gone, and my steps had well nigh slipped. I made a mistake, he said. What's the mistake he made? For I was envious of the foolish when I saw the prosperity of the wicked. When I see the success of the wicked, really I was envious at them. For there are no bands in their death. Till death, there's no problem for them. But their strength is firm. I'm weak. My head is paining. My neck is paining. My leg is paining. Asthma, TB, diabetes, cancer, blood pressure. But those people, till death, there's no problem for them. They are not in trouble as other men. As we all suffer. Some of the wicked people, they don't even suffer. Neither are they plagued like other men. They may not get any plague also. They're wicked people. Therefore, pride compasseth them about as a chain. Violence covereth them as a garment. So they are very proud. They are very violent. Their eyes stand out with fatness. His eyes stand out with fatness. They have more than heart could wish. More than what their heart could wish. The promise for a righteous person is given, the Lord will give you the desires of your heart. The promise for a righteous person is, the Lord will give you the desires of your heart. The promise for an unrighteous man is, you can get more than what your heart could wish. நமக்கு நீதிமானுக்கு இருக்கிற வாக்குத்தத்தம் கர்த்தர் உன் இருதயத்தின் வேண்டுதலை உனக்கு அருளி செய்வார். துன்மார்க்கருக்கு இருக்க வாக்கு தத்துவம் உன் இருதயம் விரும்புகிறதுல அதிகமா. அது இங்கிலீஷ்ல எப்படி இருக்குன்னா, உன்னால இவ்வளவுதான் நினைக்கவே முடியாது. அந்த அளவுக்கு அவனை அவனுக்கு செய்வாராங்க. அவனுக்கு கிடைக்குமா? அதாவது துன்மார்க்கனாவே இருந்துட்டு போலாம் போல. நமக்கு நம்ம இருதயத்தின் விருப்பம். இப்போ ஒரு உலகர் சைக்கிள் வச்சிருக்காரு, ஆசையா இருக்கு. ஒரு சின்ன பைக் இருந்தா நல்லா இருக்குமே, ஒரு பைக் இருந்தா நல்லா இருக்குமே கேட்குறாருல. ஒரு பைக் வாங்கணும் ஜோம் பண்ணி திடீர்னு பார்த்தா இந்த சைக்கிளை அவனை திருடிட்டு போவார். அங்கே ஒரு தாதா இருக்காங்க, ஒரு மோட்டார் சைக்கிள் வச்சிருந்தா பார்த்தா திடீர்னு சுமோல போகிறான், ஃபார்ச்சுனரில் போகிறான். எப்படி இருக்கண்ணா எனக்கு எப்படி ஃபார்ச்சூன் வருவான்னு நமக்கு தெரியாது. நேற்று வரைக்கும் சைக்கிள் வச்சுக்கிட்டோம்னா திடீர்னு இன்னைக்கு பார்த்தா அப்படி ஸ்டைலில் ஒயிட் அண்ட் ஒயிட் போட்டு ஆ எப்படி இருக்கிற அப்படின்ட்டு பார்க்க நம்மளை பார்த்துட்டு நமக்கு இருந்த சைக்கிளை வேணால் சுட்டு போயிடலாம். புரிய மாட்டேங்குது. நம்மளும் ஆண்டவரே நமக்கு இருக்கிற சைக்கிள் காணாமல் போடுது. அவன் துன்மார்க்கன் தாதாவாக இருக்கிறான். அவன் சைக்கிளுக்கு பதிலாக மோர் தென் வாட் இஸ் ஹார்ட் குட் விஷ் ஹி கெட்ஸ். ஸோ திஸ் இஸ் எ பிக் கன்ஃபியூஷன் ஃபார் அஸ். தே செட் தியர் மவுத் அகெயின்ஸ்ட் த ஹெவன்ஸ் அண்ட் தியர் டங் வாக் த்ரூ தி எர்த். ஜித்ரியா நான் சொன்னேன்னு சொல்லு, செக்ரட்டரியேட்டில் நான் சொன்னேன்னு சொல்லு, ஆர்டிஓ விசா அந்த ஆர்டிஓவில் எவன் இருக்கான் பாருங்க, பார்த்துங்க போயிட்டு ஒரு ஃபோன் பண்ணுங்கிறான். ஹிஸ் டங் ஏ பியூட்டி வாக் த்ரூ தி எர்த். ஆர்டிஓலன்னா ஆள் இருக்கான், செக்ரட்டரியேட்லன்னா ஆள் இருக்கான், போலீஸ் ஸ்டேஷன்லன்னா ஆள் இருக்கான். பயங்கரமான ஆட்களப்பா. அண்ட் நம்பர் ஃபைவ், தேர்ஃபோர் த பீப்புள் பீப்புள் ஆஃப் காட் ரிட்டன் ஹிதர் அண்ட் வாட்டர்ஸ் ஆஃப் அ ஃபுல் கப் ஆர் ரங் அவுட் ஆஃப் தெம். அவன் தண்ணிக்கு கிணறு தோண்டினா 40 அடியில் தண்ணி வருது. நம்ம 100 அடி 200 அடி தோண்டினாலும் உப்பு தண்ணி வருது. என்ன இது ஆச்சரியமா இருக்கு. அவனுக்கு தண்ணி சுரக்குதான். அண்ட் தே சே ஹவு டத் காட் நோ அண்ட் இஸ் தேர் நாலெட்ஜ் இன் தி ஆல் இன் த மோஸ்ட் ஹை. பிகோல் தேர் ஆர் தி அன்காட்லி ஹூ ப்ராஸ்பர் இன் த வேர்ல்ட், தே இன்க்ரீஸ் இன் ரிச்சஸ். வெரிலி ஐ ஹவ் கிளென்ஸ்ட் மை ஹேண்ட் இன் வெயின் and washed my hands in innocency. For all the day long, have I been plagued and chastened every morning. If I say I will speak this, he didn't say all these things. After that he said, if I say I will speak this, he spoke everything. எல்லாத்தையும் சொல்லிட்டு சொல்கிறேன், இப்படி நான் சொல்லுவேன் ஆனால், சொல்லி போட்டு சொல்கிறேன் I should offend against the generation of thy children. நான் பிள்ளைகளுக்கு என் சந்ததிக்கு விரோதமாக செஞ்சிடும் சொல்லப்படாது. துன்மார்க்கன் வாழ்வை பார்த்து பராமப்பலக்கூடாது. அவனுக்கு எல்லாம் நல்லா இருக்குன்னு சொல்லப்படாது. எனக்கு ஏன் இவ்வளோ கஷ்டம் அப்படின்னு சொல்லப்படாது. சொன்னால் உங்கள் பிள்ளைங்க வாழ்க்கையை நீங்கள் கெடுக்கிறீங்கன்னு அர்த்தம். If I say I will speak this, behold, I should offend against the generation of my children. When I thought to know this, it was too painful for me until I went into the sanctuary of God and understood I their end. For this only you should come into the most holy place. You should come into the very presence of God. But when I see the reward of the wicked is not because of the accident, it is not because of the pestilence, it is not because of a deadly disease, maybe cancer or something. I see their end. They never suffered anything. There's no problem as other men will have, no problem in their family. Their wives, they are scared of those wicked people. The children of the wicked people. And the wife of the children of God. Children, daddy. Why it's happening? They don't have the problem any other man will have. So they don't need to seek God. There's no need for them to repentance. There's no need for them to cleanse their hands in innocency. I tell you, there's no need for the wicked people to seek God. There's no problem for them. There's no sickness. No problem in the house. Wife doesn't speak back. Children keep their mouths shut. The servants were doing everything. Till they die, there's no need for them to seek God. They die in their sin. But in all our problems, we seek God. We want to be righteous. We want to wash our hands in innocency. We want to have our sins forgiven. We seek the mercy of God. We also die. Here we see the reward of the wicked. The reward of the wicked is not seen in the hospital. The reward of the wicked is not seen in prison doors. A martyr will also be killed. A martyr, yes, a witness for Christ will also be put in the prison. So being in the prison doesn't justify whether he is righteous or he is unrighteous. The reward of the wicked will be seen when he meets his end with no repentance, not being prepared for the eternity. He ends his life. There's no hope. There's no future. There's no mercy for him. There was an atheist. He had a very big board in his house. There is no God. My dear brother, my dear sister. Then he said, no, he put God is nowhere. God is nowhere. God is nowhere. When he was dying, he saw that board and screamed, God is nowhere. He read N-O-W-H-E-R-A. Now here. Now here. In his case, very sadly, it was become very late. All along he said, God is nowhere. When he realized God is now here, it became very late for him. There we see the reward of the wicked. It's not just because of the pestilence. It's not because of the accident. The Lord is able to protect us. But the reward of the wicked is seen in the end. How are they brought into desolation? As in a moment, they are utterly consumed with terrors. Just they close their eyes. In a moment, they are consumed with terrors. As a dream, when one awaketh. So, O Lord, when thou awakest, thou shalt despise their image. Thus my heart was grieved, and I was pricked in my reins. So foolish was I, and ignorant. I was as a beast before. Nevertheless, I am continually with thee. Thou hast holden me by my right hand. Thou shalt guide me with thy counsel, and afterward receive me to glory. Whom I have in heaven but thee? But there's none upon earth that I desire beside thee. My flesh and my heart faileth, but God is the strength of my heart. So many things against me, but my strength of my heart is God, and my portion forever is God. For lo, they that are far from thee shall perish. Thou hast destroyed all them that go a warring from thee. But it is good for me to draw nigh to God. I have put my trust in the Lord, that I may declare all thy works. God willing, I'll explain these passages more vividly later. But when we say that we shall see the reward of the wicked, it is not because somebody dies of pestilence. They all are wicked people, no. Somebody who dies in their sin, we see their end. In a moment, they are surrounded in the terror of hell. When we die in our righteousness, in a moment, we'll be surrounded by the heavenly bliss. We'll move to verses 9 and 10. Because thou hast made the Lord, which is my refuge, he tells Joshua, because thou hast made the Lord, Yahweh, which is my refuge, even the Most High, your habitation. Say, Joshua, don't worry about any of the situation. Now you are going to see a future. I'll be taken away. I just imagine it's between Moses and Joshua. Joshua, don't be worried about anything. Yahweh is my refuge. Adikalapattam. Against the horror of the day, against the terror of the night, only I could hide myself in Yahweh. Yahweh is my refuge, my adikalam, my refuge. But Joshua, you have taken that Yahweh as your dwelling place, as your habitation. Don't be afraid of anything. I will go away. But don't be afraid. Afraid of the people, those will be stoning you. Don't be afraid of the destruction that walketh in night, in darkness. Don't be afraid. Don't be afraid of the arrows. Don't be afraid of the snare of the fowler. Don't be afraid, Joshua. Yahweh is my refuge. All along Yahweh has been good unto you, unto me, Joshua. That Yahweh you have taken as your habitation, your dwelling place. Always you are in that Yahweh. You need not be afraid at all. Well, there's no need for you to be afraid. There shall no evil befall you, Joshua. Because you have taken Yahweh, my refuge, as your habitation, no evil befall you, neither shall any plague come nigh thy dwelling. Two things. Because you have taken Yahweh, your habitation, no evil befall you, no plague come nigh your dwelling. No plague. Literally no corona, no plague will come nigh your dwelling, not even nearer to your dwelling. Because the Lord is your habitation. If it has to infect you, it has to infect the Lord first. You are living in Him. It is not only this disease, any plague, any secret device, cunning device of the devil will not touch you. It will not come nigh unto you. It will not come nigh unto you. Verses 11, 12 and 13. For he shall give his angels charge over thee to keep thee in all your ways. His angels, there will be, when you dwell in the secret place of the Most High, you'll get the angelic ministration in a supernatural way. The Lord will send his angels. You cannot all explain. In a way that you cannot understand. In a mysterious way. Maybe in a human form. Maybe in a physical form. In all your ways. You are a child of God. Your ways are not bad ways. Your ways are the Lord's ways. You are walking the path of righteousness for His name's sake. He leads in the path of righteousness for His name. So you are walking in the right path. He is leading in the right. So your ways are always good ways, right ways. So in all your ways, there will be angelic ministration. There are a number of things I can say. Two specific instances in my life. Many of you might have got. Sometimes you might not have recognized it was an angel. You might not recognize it was an angel. Two things I could say. Number one, many years back, maybe in 78, 79 that time, I was ministering in Kattathurai in Kanyakumari district. From Kattathurai, 7 kilometers, I must go to a village that evening to preach. And myself, another friend who was a maths teacher with the Christian college, a Christian school, college school, MCC. school. He was a maths teacher. We both were to go to that place. So the pastor had a bullet. The pastor told me, you can take this bullet and go, but the roads are very bad. So I said, instead of driving this bullet, we can walk down. So that teacher and I, we walked down to that village. I was not very well on that day. So I preached the word of God maybe around 10 o'clock. We are walking back to Katatre, to the pastor's house. We had to come to a village road. When we are coming through, there was a very big dog, just a country dog, but a huge one. Agile. That dog was going, walking very majestically before us. We're not very curious about it. But wherever there was a hamlet, chinna kudusel varumbodhu, some 10 or 15 country dogs will come barking. But this dog will stand alone and fight against those dogs. It will bark back. And all the other dogs will be scared, putting the tail under the rear legs, hind legs, and it will go. And when we reach across the hamlet, again we see this dog going before. In that 7 kilometers, there are 4 hamlets when we are crossing, this was repeating. We just were wondering, what a mysterious protection we are getting. Unless we have got this dog going before us, we would not be able to traverse that Kacha Road. We are just seeing that and we are just talking and coming. And it was repeating in 10 or 12 places. And maybe the distance is maybe from here to where Simon was standing, that the house of the pastor where we have to go, and the dog was going before us. That's the gate. We both were seeing in front of our eyes, in front of our eyes, the dog disappeared. Oh, the dog disappeared. We both had a big shock. What is this? 7 kilometers, the dog that was going before us and making a safe journey for us just disappeared. The very next day, we contacted the pastor in that village and found, is there any dog like that? He said, no. He will charge his angels to guard you. In a mysterious way, he will help us. In supernatural way, he will help. If you know how to stand in the secret place of the Most High, I give one more instance in my personal life. You all may have instances like that. Maybe 85, 86, when I came for the full-time ministry. That Padi Pudu, it was just an open ground in those days. In that Padi Pudu, there was a small church. In that, one sister was leading that church. One day myself and my translator, we visited that sister and I wanted to give some offering to her. 50 rupees I wanted to give. It was only 85 or 86. I had only 100 rupees. That's all what I have in my house or in my pocket. That's all I have. So I asked that brother, for a rendambar var kuma. He said, no, brother. At least one umber or my, because at least by another 2 kilometers or 3 kilometers, there's no shop or anything where I can exchange it. One umber or the Kudanga Naparan Tandana. Illa brother and the Nurva Dark. He said, Lord, you know that I don't have any other money. So I walked. But there was a compelling spirit that I should give that. So Thirumbi Pono. Wait and the Nurva and the sister to Kudan. There was literally no money with me. Not in the house also. Next morning around 6 o'clock, the doorbell rang. At the time, Brother Rambi was attached to us for the help. They are like our boys who are volunteers now. There are 4 boys in the prayer house. They stayed in the prayer house. They are helping the pastors there. So Rambi was among them at that time. ஏர்லி மார்னிங் அரௌண்ட் 6 o'clock ராபி ரேங் த பெல். அண்ட் ஹி சேட், அண்ணே நேற்று ஒருத்தவங்க வந்து இந்த கவர் கொடுத்தாங்க, யாருப்பா தெரில, நான் புதுசாக இருந்தேன். சே தேர் கேன் நாட் பி ஒன் பர்சன் இன் த சர்ச் ஹூ ஆர் நாட் நோன் டு தீஸ் ஃபோர் பாய்ஸ். தீஸ் ஃபோர் பாய்ஸ் நோ எவ்ரிபடி இன் த சர்ச். ராபி சேஸ், யாருன்னு தெரில, நான் புதுசாக இருந்துச்சு. கவர் கொடுக்கும்போது சொன்னாங்க, இதை ஃபஸ்ட்டு ராபர்ட் சைமன் கையில் கொடுத்துருங்க, வேறு யார்ட்டையும் கொடுத்துறாரு. பஸ் சுந்தரம் வசதர், பஸ் சாம் சுந்தரம் வசதர் அட் த டைம். ஸோ த பர்சன் ஹூ கேவ் தட் என்வெலப் டு ராபி சார், இது யார் கையிலையும் கொடுத்துட்றாரு. ஜஸ்ட் அ சர்ப்ரைஸ். ஐ டுக் தட் என்வெலப். வென் ஐ ஓப்பன் இட், தேர் வர் 400 rupee நோட் ஆஸ் இஃப் இட் இஸ் டேக்கன் ஃப்ரம் ஆர்பிஐ. Fresh notes, not touched by anybody like that. Fresh notes. Four notes in an envelope. Then I asked Ravi, what time he received? No exaggeration, I tell you, exactly the same minute when I was giving that 100 rupees that to that sister, somebody was giving 400 rupees to Ravi to give it to me. Till this day, we don't know who that person. Till this day, we don't know who that person was. If it's a human being, probably, maybe, when I share this testimony somewhere, I may, that person may come and say, it's I. If anybody's here, you can please tell me. Otherwise, probably I may meet that person in heaven. Or that must be an angel. So when you are in the secret place of the Most High, you will have angelic ministration in different ways. So the Lord will give His angels charge over thee. Okay, take care of my son. Take care of Salvam. Take care of Vinay, Vijay. He'll give charge. Take care of him. Take care of Robert. The Lord shall give His angels charge over you to keep you in all your ways. What they do? They shall bear you up in their hands, lest you dash your foot against a stone. I don't have time to explain everything. Please listen. Have you ever seen anybody dashed against a big boulder or a mountain and fell down? In Tamil we say pul tadiki bailvan. Pul tadiki bailvan. Maran tadiki yaradhu ulundirukkaangala? Oru periya maran enna tadikichu na ulunditen. Ana oru bailvan andal edho oru pullila kaal madichu na ulundirum. நமக்கு வர்ற டேஞ்சர் ஒரு நாளும் மலை கிடையாது. நம்ம விழுறதெல்லாம், எங்கள் வீட்டில் ஒரு பெரிய டேபிள் இருந்துச்சு, ஒரு பீரோ இருந்துச்சு, அந்த பீரோவில் முட்டி நான் கீழே விழுந்துட்டேன். யாராவது விழுந்திருக்கீங்களா? அப்படி விழுந்திருந்தாலும் பாவம், அவங்களுக்கு ஒன்றும் பண்ண முடியாது. பீரோ தடுக்கி விழுந்துட்டேன், கீழே தண்ணி இருந்துச்சு, தெரில கால் வலிக்கிடுச்சு. அந்த கீழே விழ வச்சது தண்ணி தானே, உன்னை கீழே விழ வச்சது தண்ணி தானே, உன்னை கீழே விழ வச்சது அந்த ஒரு சின்ன கயிறு தானே, உன்னை கீழே விழ வச்சது அங்கே கிடந்த பிளாஸ்டிக் பேப்பர் தானே. ஹலோ, கல் தடிக்கு தான் கீழே விழுவோம், புல் தடிக்கு தான் கீழே விழுவோம், பாறை தடிக்கு மரந்தடிக்கு கீழே விழ மாட்டோம். அநேகர் கீழே விழுந்ததெல்லாம் புல் தடிக்கு. புல் தடிக்கு தான் கீழே விழுந்துட்ட பிரதர், தம்பி புல் தடிக்கு தான் விழுந்திருக்கிற. ஆனால் விழுந்து மண்டை உடஞ்சி போச்சு, பல் உடஞ்சி போச்சு, கால் உடஞ்சி போச்சு, எழும்ப முடியலை. இவ்வளோ ப்ராப்ளமும் வாழ்க்கையில் வந்ததுக்கு தீர்க்க தரிசனமாக சொல்கிறேன், உன் ப்ராப்ளம் எல்லாத்துக்கும் காரணம் நீ இந்த புல் தடிக்கு விழுந்தனால. Now you have broken your crown. நெத்தி உடஞ்சு போச்சு, But if you know how to stand in the secret place of the Most High, they will bear you in their hands, that your foot will not dash against a stone, not against a cross. Thou shalt tread upon the lion and the adder. The young lion and the dragon shalt thou trample under feet. He shall give his angels charge over thee to keep thee in all your ways, that they shall bear thee up in their hands, lest your foot dash against a stone. And you shall tread upon serpent, adder, lion, young lion, the different forms of the devil. I'll explain in another time. I just read from verse 14 to 16, a number of points there. God willing, we shall meditate later. Verses 14 to 16, because he hath set his love upon me, therefore will I deliver him. I will set him on high because he hath known my name. Verse 15, he shall call upon me and I will answer him, and I will be with him in trouble. I will deliver him and I will honor him. With long life will I satisfy him and I will show him my salvation. There are three things. All of a sudden, when Moses was talking to Joshua, I think the anointing of the Lord came upon Moses, and Moses started prophesying. God was speaking through Moses, for he had set his love upon me. Now God is speaking. 14, 15, 16. Through the human agency, God is speaking. Because he had set his love upon me, therefore will I deliver him. Three things. You can just make a note of it. Number one, because you set your love upon Yahweh. Number two, because you know his name. Number three, verse 15, because you shall call upon Yahweh. Three things, because you have set your love upon him. Number two, because you have known his name. Number three, because you shall call upon him. There are eight things the Lord can do in your life. Therefore, I will deliver him. I will deliver him. Number two, I will set him on high. I will set him on high. Number three, I will answer him. Number four, I will be with him in trouble. Number five, I will deliver him. Number six, I will honor him. Number seven, I will satisfy him with long life. Number eight, I will show him my salvation. Is another 8-point message. When you know him, because you set your love on him, because you know his name, because you call upon him. The Lord says, it's not Moses to Joshua. To Moses, the Lord was speaking. Yeah, I know him. Because he has set his love on me. He has not set his love on anybody else. He has not set his love on anybody else. He has not set his love on any woman. He has not set his love on any man. She has not set her love on any man. Not any property. Not any earthly success, not even a ministerial success. He has set his love on me. Because he has set his love on me, because he knows my name, he is El Shaddai, he is Yahweh Yireh, Yahweh Nissi, Yahweh Sitkanu, because he knows my name. He has set his love on me, because he knows my name, because he calls on me. Why I call on him? Because I know who he is. I know he is Yahweh Yireh. He shall see to my need. I know he is Yahweh Nissi. He is the banner of victory for me. Because I know his name, I will call on him. How do I know his name? Because with no reservation, in all his totality, I set my love on him. My love is only Jesus. My love is not anything else. Some people, they set their love on earthly things. My dear brother, my dear sister, I still remember at the time that I got saved, I was baptized, attending Sister Saran or the fellowship, a young fellow, he came for baptism. He had a long side bush. And sister, somebody who was counseling said, Thambi, nee baptism edukapore idellam cut panniru. Immediately that boy said, Sattala adukamate. Next Sunday, sister in the message, I was just a young boy at that time. Next Sunday, sister said in that message, Avan veeriye mayirla vachirukka. Many people, many boys, many girls, really they set their love on the mayir. Konjanaali onnu illama poyidudhu. Andha mayir mele veera vachikittirukkaran. Ipdi beard, apdi beard, ipdi makeup, apdi makeup. அதுக்கு சாஃப்ட்வேரே இருக்கா இந்த மயிர அலங்கரி போடா மயிர அம்மா வெரி பிட்டியபிள் திங் பட் த லார்ட் வில் டெலிவர் ஹிம் த லார்ட் வில் செட் ஆன் ஹை த லார்ட் வில் ஆன்சர் ஹிம் த லார்ட் வில் ஷோ ஹிஸ் சால்வேஷன் டு சம்படி டு ஹூம் ஹி ஹஸ் செட் ஹிஸ் லவ் ஆன் மீ நாட் ஆன் மயிர் ஹி ஹஸ் செட் ஹிஸ் லவ் ஆன் மீ Goal, God's will to be done in my life. I should please God in my life. Because I have set my love on Him, I will know His name. Because I know His name, I call on Him. When I call on Him, He answers me. He sets me on high. He shows His salvation to me. 8 things He does. God Himself promises. God Himself promises. Because He knows my need. Then God says, because Simon has set his love on me. Will God say that, Simon? Will God say that? The young boys here? Will God say that? You have set totally your love on me. It's not Robert says, not your parents say, not the church say. God should reveal himself and say, I know Simon, he has set his total love on me. Because he has set his love on me, he knows my need. What I can do for him. Because he knows my name, he calls on me. Because he calls on me, 7 things he says, I will. What are the 7 things? I just read that before I conclude. I will set him on high. I will deliver him. I will set him on high. And I will be with him. In trouble, I will deliver him, I will honor him, I will satisfy him, I will show him my salvation. A very simple thing. These 3 things you do, the Lord promises he will do these 8 things. Shall we close our eyes? All these blessings, if there is someone who dwells in the secret place of the Most High. It is to someone who dwells in the secret place of the Most High. God willing, I'll help you how we can reach the secret place of the Most High next Sunday. Be not afraid of any terror, terror by day or horror by night. Even don't worry about a stone on your way or a grass that could make you fall down. He'll be a God around you. Will set his angels to watch over. Just do those 3 things. Especially my heart is going to the boys and the girls here. Can you set your love on him? Can the Lord says, yes, I know this girl, my child. She has set her love on me. Not the fashions of the world. Not on the perishing things. Not on the worldly success. He, she has set his or her love on me. I will set him on high. I will deliver him. I will honor him. I will show him my salvation. I will satisfy. The Spirit of the Lord is speaking to you. Purisha Namalava. Puralaka Rasha Namalava.